Welcome back to Fox 8 News in the Morning. Battling the coronavirus and then recovering can take weeks, but that doesn't mean patients are in the clear. Now some patients are dying of strokes, even heart attacks. Dr. Shazam Hussein, he's with the Cleveland Clinic, a neurologist there. He joins us live to kind of talk about what's going on. Doctor, thank you so much for being with us this morning. I want to first start with the blood clots. We've heard this story of a Broadway star getting his right leg amputated because of a blood clot. So why are clotting issues being seen in patients now?
Yeah, it's an interesting question. As the virus, now we are knowing more and more about it. First, you know, people were really focused in on the fever and the shortness of breath as the main symptoms, but we are seeing now that there's a particularly clotting problem that seems to be coming with the virus. As you mentioned, can cause clotting in pretty much anywhere in the body, the legs, the lungs, and in particular also strokes and heart attacks are a particular concern in people who have the COVID virus.
Are these more rare cases, or is this just something new that they're figuring out because it's basically a work in progress?
Yeah, there are a lot of things that are just being discovered as we learn more and more about the virus. We were talking to our colleagues in New York and Detroit, and they seem to be seeing a lot of stroke patients showing up to the hospital and then testing positive for COVID. And interestingly, these were young patients, healthy patients, not who you would normally think of having a stroke. So a particular finding that people are starting to notice, and again, from around the world, it's nice that the community is being able to share this information so that we can all understand what's going on.
We have a producer here. Both her parents got tested and were positive for COVID-19. Well, they recovered a few weeks later, and now her dad just had a heart attack. Yeah. What is the correlation between the two?
Well, there's probably two things with the COVID virus. First of all, we know that just generally any kind of respiratory infection, like even the flu virus, does increase your risk somewhat of having stroke and heart attack. But in particular with COVID, it does seem to be a little bit more than that. It's actually inducing more clotting to happen in people who have the virus.
And are they noticing these symptoms after they're leaving the hospital or after they've dealt with the virus that should trigger some kind of reaction to call a doctor?
Well, certainly it's actually being with the COVID virus seems to be could happen anywhere within the course. So again, speaking about the colleagues that we've talked to in New York, where there's a lot of COVID, a lot of these people didn't have any other symptoms of COVID and actually just presented to the hospital with stroke. So I think one should always be wary of stroke symptoms. The other interesting thing that we've been finding is people have seemed to have been having a lot of fear about coming to the hospital, which
yes,
particularly in the situation of a stroke or heart attack, could be very, very dangerous. It's still very important to get to the hospital because that's going to be the best place for you to get treatment in the situation of that.
And Dr. Hussein, before we wrap this up, talk about those symptoms that people need to be aware of.
Yeah, for stroke, we use an acronym called BFAST. So B stands for balance, any kind of balance difficulty. E for eyes, if there's any trouble with your vision. F standing for face, any droopiness on one side of the face or the other. A for arm, any kind of weakness in the arm or leg. And then S standing for speech, speaking difficulties. And then the T is there to remind us how important time is in this situation. That's time to call 911. Call an ambulance and get into the hospital right away. Hospitals are very safe. We've taken precautions against the COVID virus, so there's no reason to be afraid to come in. You'll be very well protected and taken care of.
Yeah, the ER seems to be very quiet is what we're hearing. Dr. Hussein, thank you for being with us this morning. We appreciate the information.